Tamava, 17 years of age. Lakhichuk, 19 years of age. Both of them preparing for their fourth bout here at Kielce 2021. And you can see, if you just keep your eye on the boxing ring, you see the volunteers in the ring, making sure that COVID-19 protocols are followed, everything wiped down and sanitized in between each of the contests.
Please, into the red corner, from Uzbekistan, Nigina Uktamova.
So here comes Nigina Uktamova, 2020 national youth champion in the 57 kilogram division. And the year before that, in 2019, she was the continental queen, taking Asian junior gold at 52 kilograms. She's got junior titles in her ranks domestically as well. Very decorated boxer, terrific performer. And in her semi-final, she produced terrific responses in round 2 and 3 to win on a unanimous points decision verdict against Anastasia Kirenko of Russia. So she, just a final slug of water before making her way back up into the boxing ring for her fourth bout here at Kielce 2021, affording a bit of a smile, as relaxed as can possibly be. As we've mentioned, from her highly decorated career so far, very capable boxer, success on the continental stage, but here, one win away from occupying the top rostrum
at the global stage here at Kielce 2021.
Nigina Uktamova into the red corner. Her opponent is Kristina Lakhichuk. Produced some brilliant back foot boxing in her semi-final. Very cool when under pressure to eliminate Karolina Ampolska of Poland. And you can imagine what pressure it was to be facing a home boxer in a bout to determine who's going through to contest gold. But she dealt with the pressure, she dealt with the reputation and ability of her opponent, kept her cool under fire, and she too, just a brief smile for the cameras. Wouldn't think that these boxers are about to contest world championship gold, the composure they're demonstrating, as we have judges from Croatia, Poland, Chinese Taipei, Mongolia, and the United States of America scoring this one using the 10-point must system. So all the hard work done for both of these boxers now, and really not much the coaches can tell them. The coaches will have watched the film, they'll have given them their instructions, mouthpiece inserted, head guard strapped in place, gloves where they need to be, and indeed the protective cup. So once the referee has made the inspection, both boxers will be called to center ring for the final instructions. What a moment for these two.
Heads up, no punches to the back of the head. Keep your punches up, no holding. Listen to my command. Good luck.
So Sadie Duffy of Ireland is the referee. And we are underway. First round action in the 54 kilogram bantamweight division, the gold medal bout between boxers from Uzbekistan and Ukraine. The boxer in red is Uzbekistan athlete Nigina Uktamova. Her opponent, boxing out of the southpaw stance wearing blue, is Kristina Lakhichuk of Ukraine. And again, as wow, that is a real tangle Lakhichuk got herself into, in between the strands there. And right on the resumption, Uktamova helps herself to an eye-catching right hand. Almost thought about a corkscrew, she turned her palm upwards, but whatever shot it was, it landed solidly. And here we see the pattern we expected. Uktamova on the front foot, Lakhichuk looking to employ that back foot boxing that served her so well throughout the tournament and in the semi-final in particular. So Uktamova looking to get over her front foot and get into range, flailing with punches, but did score with a good left hand to the body. Beautiful footwork from Lakhichuk to get herself out of the corner and turn the tables on her opponent wearing red. So just over a minute gone in the opening round, Uktamova fainting with the head and the feet who's trying to draw a lead that she can perhaps counter. Lakhychuk content to have her hand down by her belt line as she, on the back foot, looking for counter shots herself. Beautiful right hand out of the orthodox stance from the woman in red as she goes in pursuit of Lakhychuk once again and lands a flashing right hand around the corner. Now Lakhychuk is trying to fight fire with fire here, but I'm not sure that's going to be the correct tactic. But credit to her, because as a back foot boxer, you don't want to be going in reverse all the time. And occasionally, you've got to stand your ground and try and push back the pressure boxer just to give the judges the impression that you're not trying to nick it. And of course, you don't want to do any such thing with world championship gold at stake. Coming forward once again with a foray is Uktamova. And a couple of that four-shot cluster did get through. Lakhychuk going down to the body, trying to establish her own right jab on that back foot. But Lakhychuk presenting a dynamic opponent in there. Nice left-hand lead from Lakhychuk, who at this type of territory is very difficult to beat. But did you see Uktamova employ the layback, trigger in with quick feet, and she was the only one who landed during that previous exchange a few moments ago. Lakhychuk skipping out to the space of ring center once again, going for a left hand over the top, but couldn't quite find the range. Pinned on the ropes momentarily, fights her way off there. Uktamova unrelenting in her pursuit, looking to close the distance, bobbing and weaving in front of her opponent. But then credit to Lakhychuk, she kept the attack going. And after Uktamova evaded a cluster of straights, she was picked off by two of them, and then a single right hand which followed. And that is terrific from Lakhychuk, the back foot boxer, keeping her front foot pressure going in waves. 10-second clapper sound. We're in the closing stages of the first round. And again, Lakhychuk making a point of standing her ground and trying to back up the aggressor. Very good opening 3 minutes to begin this 54-kilogram bantamweight gold medal bout. Will the pressure of Uktamova be rewarded, or will it be the back foot boxing of Lakhychuk that's preferred? And that's what the judges have gone for across the board.
Yeah, I'd have given her that round. I thought just boxing off that back foot, she did. She found the gap. She found some really nice counters. As you said, every now and again, she does need to step in and meet Uktamova, or Uktamova will just keep coming forward. And that kind of fighting in reverse, no matter how effective, sometimes the judges don't really like it. It's not a great look. It's a great matchup, this, because as you said, you've got somebody who's comfortable under pressure, boxing off the back foot. I've seen Lakhychuk do it all tournament against somebody who will keep coming forward. Uktamova, you don't exactly have to go looking for her. She's not hard to hit, but she has got an engine and she will keep coming forward. At some point, she'll be hoping that pressure really starts to tell, but it needs to be in this round is the thing, because she's dropped that first.
Round two. And she dropped the first unanimously, all five of the scoring judges preferring the back foot boxing of Lakhychuk, who has started this round, pinging her opponent once again with straight shots while backing up away from her advancing opponent in red. Now, in her semi-final, as mentioned, Uktamova produced a terrific response in the second round after conceding the first. She's got to do the same thing here. But Lakhychuk is very difficult to fluster. Just look how calm she is up there in the boxing ring. She was all smiled before the opening bell, but here she's presenting a poker face. And despite the pressure she's been put under, her expression never changes. She just gets back to her space, ties her opponent up intelligently. And at this type of territory, well, Lakhychuk is proving to be the superior boxer. Look at that, pivoting out of the corner, skipping off to her right in an anti-clockwise direction. And Uktamova has to reset her feet, come again, and she takes a left hook as Lakhychuk is on the way out. So just over a minute gone in the second round. Now referee Sadie Duffy has spoken to Lakhychuk about holding as Uktamova comes into the pocket and lands a good right hand. But that is part of her armory. She boxes on the back foot, and if she gets put under pressure, if she can't get out of there with her feet, she will clamp up her opponent and waltz her out to the space of the boxing ring. But as Andy's been pointing out, here in Aiba boxing, that has been penalized sometimes quite quickly. So Lakhychuk won't want to pick up a warning as Uktamova comes forward once again. A roundhouse speculative right wasn't too far away. Lakhychuk looking to get back to the space of ring center. And despite being the aggressor, Uktamova has got to keep her shape here. She'll know more than anybody that her aggression needs to be effective and not just going forward letting her hands go, but not really finding accurate punches. There's a clever veteran move from Lakhichuk once again, getting the head of her opponent beneath her armpit, and there's no way that Uktamova could generate any type of power from that posture. Uktamova trying to dig in right and left hooks, but she's being frustrated here by a very clever display from Lakhichuk. But again, that stern admonishment from the referee, and she may well be walking a tightrope in terms of employing that tactic further. But Uktamova coming forward, willing herself into the fray and letting her hands go. Did get through with some arcing punches, backing her opponent up to the corner. But Lakhichuk remaining unflustered. But Uktamova just giving the impression of getting closer now, and Lakhichuk is looking to initiate clinches more frequently. Look at Uktamova fighting furiously to try and get her hands free and put them onto her opponent. Both boxers exchanging shoeshine shots to the body. And for the first time, deep into this second round, is Lakhichuk just beginning to feel the pressure being exerted by Uktamova. Terrific second round of boxing. And it's all tied up, because we have 10-9 across the board. Uktamova's incessant front foot pressure has tied it up, just as she did in the semi-finals, and she looks the fresher as we prepare for the third.
Absolutely, and just as we were saying before the start of that round, that was the key to that round. Would she be able to do enough during the course of that second round? Would she get to her quick enough in that second round to win it? Midway through the round, I'd say Lakhichuk was winning the round. She was still finding her on the way in, but she kept going, kept going, kept going, and piling it on in the last 30 seconds there in particular has given her a chance, because if she loses that round, then it's a mountain to climb. And what Lakhichuk has got to watch out for here as well is the holding, as you pointed out. Uktamova has just got to keep doing what she's doing. Lakhichuk has got to try and find an answer, but she can't hold too much, or I think a point could go, and that would be fatal.
So into the third and final round then of a 54-kilogram bantamweight gold medal bout that is in the balance. The boxer wearing blue conceded the second round for all five scoring judges after she swept the opening round unanimously. So just a bit of a running repair required to the head guard. Now you see Sadie Duffy saying that even though his face is behind a face covering, the coach isn't issuing instructions during that interlude to repair the head guard.
Break.
That adjustment has been made and the action resumes. Break. So both boxers have to heed the commands of the referee. Stop, box, break and time. They're the instructions that the referee's vocabulary is built around, as Uktamova comes forward but takes a right left from Lakhichuk as she spins off to the space of ring center. Oh, that's a beautiful right hand landed by the woman in red. And Lakhichuk, well, credit to her, she is digging deep and trying to demonstrate to Uktamova that she is still full of fight in this battle for world championship gold. She lands a right hook around the corner, but this is Uktamova's contest to get onto the front foot and engage in trade-offs. And credit to Lakhichuk, the back foot boxer, perhaps doesn't have the energy to get up on her toes now. And before that holding, I was going to say, she's not looking to hold, she's looking to say, okay, let's do this, and trade off with her opponent at center ring. There's a nice check right hand from Lakhichuk. And this one, even though it's Aiba boxing, has turned into a fight, but it is not a swing up. There is still plenty of culture behind those shots, plenty of education, and it's Uktamova who gets the better of the coming together on the ropes. Just beyond the midpoint of the second final round, and what a left cross landed by Lakhichuk. Again, she's tying up Uktamova. And to me, Lakhichuk has the look of a boxer who can only fight in spurts, but she's picking her spots very well. And in this type of territory, Uktamova looking to let her hands go to the body. Beautiful right hand landed by the woman in red, and then bustling away with punches above the belt line just as we approach a minute to go mark. Wide-eyed and concentrated is Uktamova, looking to work her way back into the breach, and lands an overhand right, but is countered by a solid shot from Lakhichuk. Terrific third and final round, demonstrating just how much world championship gold means to both of these boxers. Good left hand to the body landed by Uktamova a few moments ago. Who can produce some sustained quality in the final seconds as a left-right combination pings home for Uktamova? She's boxing in a different posture now, hands down by her belt line, and Lakhichuk continuing to dig deep And again, she deserves immense credit. She appeared rather the worst for wear at the end of the second round, but my goodness, hasn't she come out strong and is giving it absolutely everything. But for what it's worth, I don't feel it's been enough in this third and final round, but this is going to come down to the verdict of the five scoring judges as both boxers engage in a trade-off once again just before the closing bell. Terrific action across three 3-minute rounds. Absolutely sensational stuff. There's jubilation in both corners. This one was in the balance coming into round three. And both boxers met one another head on. They both enjoyed success in that round. I happen to think it's the woman in red who edged the third, but this is going to come down to the five judges seated around the boxing ring. What a contest.
Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. I would agree. I think Atamova has got that final round because I think she just edged it in two phases, really. She was on the front foot in the first half of it, trying to press home that advantage. Mikichuk threw in some good shots off the back foot, but then towards the end, the Mikichuk got a bit more desperate, and Atamova, boxing on the back foot, managed to pick her off on the way in. So for me, it's red.
Win on box with split decision. From the red corner,
and here is confirmation. A split decision victory for Nagina Uktamova. Five wins out of five here in Kyoto 2021. And the Uzbekistan boxer
is the
world youth champion in the 54-kilogram bantamweight division. She is absolutely elated, well she should be, acknowledging all sides of the Halalegian off here, and is receiving a terrific reception. A terrific tournament concludes with world championship gold for Nagina Uktamova.